everyone. It's attorney Jasmine Robinson of Jazz Talks Law.
Hello, everyone. It's Bria Stevens with Live Laugh Law.
And we are here today to talk with you guys about some of the things that us Black females face in the legal profession. So the first thing that we wanted to address is if natural hair is unprofessional. So looking at me and Bria, would you hire us? Would our hair, our lovely braids, would they keep you from making that deal, from giving us that offer letter? As Black women in the legal profession, that's something that we face daily.
When it was interview season, I did not have these braids in. One, because I thought they were unprofessional. So I remember I was talking to Jasmine right after I got the braids in. I was like, oh, I'm going to a lunch with a few attorneys tomorrow, and I'm nervous because I have my hair in these braids. Like, I mean, it wasn't like I was going to take them out. I had just paid $200 to get them done. So I wasn't taking them out, but it was just like, I felt like it was a hindrance. It almost made me like self-conscious because I did have these braids in. I would have felt much more comfortable going in if my hair was straight.
And the problem is, you know, we sometimes feel like we have to change our natural hair even though others don't. And for someone who isn't in a practice setting, I'm an attorney, but I run my own organization, so I'm not in a practice setting every day. I don't feel the pressures to change my hair. But if you are trying to work for a big law firm, for example, when it comes time to prepare for that interview, you're going to ask yourself to blow my hair out or to not blow my hair out. And honestly, that's up to you. If you know when you join that firm that you're going to want to wear your natural hair, and if that could be an issue for you down the line, I think you should present yourself as you are. It's, to be very frank with you guys, it's 2017. It's time, as of right now, diversity is becoming the cool thing in professions across the land. So it's time for them to accept us for who we are. So don't be afraid to wear your natural hair. If they don't accept you, then maybe that's not a good fit for you in the long run. That could foreshadow some other issues that you might face at the firm. But if you're comfortable with, you know, having to straighten your hair, then that's okay too. It's totally, that's a decision that you have to make and you have to be comfortable with.
Yes, I totally agree with Jasmine. My thing is, during interviews, I kept my hair natural, but I slicked it back into like a small bun. I didn't wear my usual puff or my usual wash and go. And that was what I was willing to accept because I knew what I was looking for and I knew what these companies were looking for. So I knew it wasn't appropriate for me to walk in with my big hair. Of course, I really do wish that it was appropriate, but we haven't advanced that far. And I look forward to the day that I can walk into work with my big curls and I'm just looked at as if I had my hair was straight.
So, and one other tip that I would suggest for you guys, if you're trying to make a decision whether you need to blow out your hair or not blow out your hair, look into some of the other people at the firm, some of the partners, some of the associates. How are they wearing their hair? Have conversations with them. You know, is it okay, you know, if I just slick my fro to the back and do like a bun or what have you? Just do a little research about the firm and their culture and making sure that's something you want to be a part of.
Now, there are other hair things to deal with hair that we do have a choice about. Those things might be the unicorn scarf. You know, everyone does it. You know, when you have a bad hair day, that's something that we can make a choice about. And 9 times out of 10, it's not going to be appropriate to go into work with that unicorn scarf.
Yeah.
I know I have those days when I want to put mine on, and some I've done it like once being in law school, but just when you're going into work, that's probably not the best idea. Mm-hmm. And when it comes to dyeing your hair, so I know we like to, you know, do the blondes and the reds, and it's getting this summer, and we all want to have, you know, our bright hair. But that's also a choice that we can make. It's not what grows naturally out of our head. So it's a choice you can make, and it might be more professional not to have your blonde hair. I know when I'm working over the summer, it's going to be my birthday, and I was just thinking how I want this blonde bob, and it's going to be so cute. But when the time comes, I'm probably going to rethink that decision just because it's not the most professional choice to make, and I am trying to portray myself in the best light possible because at the end of the day, these people are judging me based on my hair, based on everything. Even though that's not, you know, ideal, it's happening.
Yeah. And that's why we were doing this YouTube, because we know as Black women, we face more barriers than others do, if we're being honest. And these are things that we deal with every day. Susie might not have to worry about if she puts some blonde on her hair, but we do. Unfortunately, that's just that's where we are in 2017. And we just want to help you guys deal with that, what we've dealt with.
Yes. So the next issue that we are going to address is how to dress for an interview. I know oftentimes it can be hard for a Black woman to find a nice pair of slacks that don't hug all her curves, or a nice skirt that isn't too short and rides up when she sits down. It can be very hard for us to find the apparel to wear to an interview. So we want to discuss that and how we go about finding those things.
One tip or suggestion that I have for you guys is if you are one of my sisters that are a little bit more curvy up top in the waist, in the chest area, consider doing shirts that don't have the buttons in the front. Because if you are one of my sisters with a big chest, I love you all, but the buttons right here, if the shirt could pull a little bit or anything could happen, we don't want someone to say, oh, she doesn't get the job because I could see between that little hole right there. So if you are one of my sisters with a bigger chest, consider wearing a shirt that doesn't have buttons. That's just like a regular like blouse, like a higher neckline or what have
you. Also, something to try is when I buy my suit skirts, I always go a size up. Like, no matter what it is, and I feel if I feel comfortable, like, oh, this is the perfect fit, I choose to go a size up just because I don't want it to look tight. I would always rather them say, oh, her skirt is a little loose, than, oh, her skirt is hugging her curves too tight. So just when it feels comfortable, think about going a size up from there, just because you don't want to have any issues about your clothes being too tight.
And another practical tip with that, I don't know about you, Bria, but my weight loss journey in law school was crazy. One minute I was losing weight, one minute I was gaining weight. So going up a size could definitely be helpful down the line if you do end up picking up pounds a few pounds your second year like I did. And then also another practical tip, most of my suits and things that I got for law school came right from the thrift store. I'm not about spending hundreds and hundreds of dollars on suits, and a lot of times the thrift stores have very nice suits. You would never guess the ones that I got from the thrift stores and the ones that I didn't.
And another store to check is H&M. And we had oral arguments on Friday, and my friend walked in. She had this very nice pantsuit, and I was like, oh, girl, where did you get that suit? Like, that's really nice. And she said H&M. So yesterday I went to H&M, and they had $34.99 blazers and pants. So that's pretty much a bargain when it comes to suits. Besides getting them at the thrift store, that's pretty cheap for a nice suit. And it didn't look like it was from H&M or Forever 21. So check out other stores as well. Although I know H&M pants don't fit us the best. I struggle with them. But, you know, go in there, try on a few sizes. Maybe you'll get lucky and find something.
And if you haven't guessed it already, me and Bria are both wearing typical interview attire, just to give you guys an idea. So Bria has on a lovely blazer. It's cut very high, so there's nowhere for the eye to wander. You can't see it on the camera, but she has on a full-length dress. And for me, I have on a high-cut dress as well, a little button detail for fun. And my skirt flares out a little bit. And if I was going into an interview, I'd actually put a blazer on top of this. But if I was going to work and I already had the job, I would probably put like a cardigan on top of this and some cute shoes.
Yes, and my dress is cap sleeve, so I would never just wear this. I would always have to have something over it.
Another thing that I wanted to mention in regards to this topic is your makeup. It's very, very important to, you know, put on a little bit of makeup to bring out your features, but to not overdo it for that interview. So one rule of thumb is no red lipstick. And that's more so not just too red lipstick, but anything that's too bright or that stands out just a little bit too much. When you're talking with your interviewers, you just want them to be focused on the right things and not on your bright lipstick or your bright eyeliner or what have you. So no red lipstick or no makeup or foundation or whatever that just kind of takes the focus off you and what you have to offer.
Yes, as you all might know, I am a makeup enthusiast. I have so much makeup. I've been trying to learn more about makeup.
You had to teach me a few things.
But the way to go for the interview or even just going to work is the no makeup makeup look. So watch some no makeup makeup tutorials. Just, you know, maybe a little highlight, but you don't want to be glowing in the dark when you go to work. So as Jazz said, no crazy lipstick. We both chose a nude lip today. We kept it calm. I know Jazz loves her red lip, so she kept it calm for y'all today, just so we can be an example of what you should be like when you're going into the professional setting.
Mm-hmm. And even things, I don't think we mentioned, we said we were going to talk about this, but our jewelry. I think our jewelry right now is very appropriate. Bria has on some very cute pearl earrings, and I have on hoops that I would probably wear as an employee and not as an interviewee, but just to give you an example of that as well.
Yes, and I did like a mock interview with Career Services, and my mom bought me these hoop earrings. They're probably like this big. They weren't huge. She bought them for me for Christmas. They were real gold, and I was like, oh, you know, these are very conservative. But I went there, and they're like, no, those are too big. You need to tone it down a little bit, maybe just do a stud. But this was for an interview, so I did take their advice and I didn't wear the hoop. But as Jazz said, maybe as an employee those would be appropriate, but going into the interview it wasn't appropriate. And so as you guys can probably tell from like our conversation, the interview is like you need to be 100%, like 120%. When you're going to work, you need to be 100%. So there's a little bit of difference between the interview and the everyday going to work. You can be a little bit more relaxed, a little bit yourself, but you still need to keep it professional.
And the whole idea of this is we want them to focus on you, and we don't want them to have any little thing to say like, well, she wore those big earrings, so we aren't going to hire her, even though she's on law review, even though she's in the top of her class, or what have you. Because unfortunately, that's what we face. We might be just as qualified, but they might nitpick, if you will, based on one or two little things that they really shouldn't be considering.
And one more thing that I want to add, we're talking about interviews and the job, but another thing to keep in mind is when you go visit law schools. So they don't say that you have to wear business professional or business casual, but that's something to keep in mind. If you're going to a law school, don't go in there in some booty shorts and a tank top. Like, please don't. It might be nice to put on some slacks and a button up, or, you know, a nice shirt and a blazer and some jeans. Just keep it a little bit more professional than you would if you were just going to hang with your girls. So that's something else to keep in mind.
Absolutely. No booty shorts.
I've seen it. So this is the end of part one, and we will have part two coming soon. So make sure you subscribe and stay tuned to our channels. You can follow me on Instagram at @LiveLaughLaw_. I just made a new Instagram dedicated solely to LiveLaughLaw. So that's the future, the direction we're headed in for the future.
Yes, and you can follow us at Jazz Talks Law, JASTALKS Law, LAW, very simple. And we are just launching our website, and we have some great, great things in store. So please check that out for more information about me being your law school coach, which is what you need to get through this law school admissions process. And you can even get our free law school admissions timeline by subscribing to our weekly email. So visit our website, www.jazztalkslaw.com.
And part two is coming soon. Thanks, y'all.
Bye.